Guys, welcome to this new video. Today we will actually speak about the elimination stage of the World Cup. So we will actually make a quick analysis on the chart that that we have right now, that we are right now for the World Cup. I have to say, yesterday the Belgium winning over England, it was kind of a not a surprise, but it was actually a thing that almost all of us we were thinking there was something that it was good for Belgium. But let's go to analyze a bit what we have in front of us. Belgium, yes, it will actually play the eighth finals against Japan. Yes, it's an organized team. It's very solid team, but of course it's the weakest eighth final among the one that has to play Belgium or England, because England has to play against Colombia. Colombia is full of talents; it's a very dangerous team. But let's take in consideration. Let's speak about the option that both teams will qualify for the quarterfinals. Belgium, it's on the side, left side of the chart with Brazil, Mexico, Uruguay, Portugal, France and Argentina. So basically all the teams excluded Japan are teams they are capable of winning this World Cup. In the other side though, England, yes, has the very tough eighth final against Colombia, but then if they would win, they have to play against Switzerland or Sweden. Both teams are affordable. England could beat them easy, especially because it was one of the most impressive teams in this World Cup. And then, of course, there's the other two games. There's Croatia against Denmark. Croatia will win. Croatia will win. And Spain against Russia, most likely Spain will win. And then we will have a quarterfinal, Spain-Croatia. That's a bit unpredictable because both teams are very, very good teams, full of talents. But now we have to actually think about this thing. Probably England will beat Colombia, and then it will beat on quarterfinal Sweden or Switzerland. In my opinion, Switzerland. And then basically they have to play only one game of higher level against a competitor that could win the World Cup to access the finale. And honestly, this was very lucky for England. Usually in her history didn't have much luck in football at all, but now I have to say this is an highway to the finale, in my opinion. It was already one of my favorite teams to the final victory, but I have to say the right side of the chart is it contains only, in my opinion, Croatia and Spain, that they could say they could actually beat England in an elimination game. In the other side, I mean, the other side is absolutely like a minefield. You can actually lose against everyone. So what I'm saying that my predictions with England winning the World Cup or at least qualifying for the finale, it's actually going to happen, in my opinion, because this is the chance. Southgate's team was impressing me, not only for talents, because England always had talents, but for the complexity and the solidity of the 11, and also they have a crazy bench that includes crazy talents. But I think that I can feel is the motivation and the kind of the empathy and the alchemia that Southgate was creating. This is not like the previous England's. And I have to say, this is quite a good thing, because I mean, I was growing up with great English national teams. Let's not forget that in the 2000 And in the middle of 2000s, they were having the best midfield in the world with Paul Scholes, Gerrard and Lampard, Joe Cole, of course. So I think this is the chance. Please comment below. I'm interested to know your opinion. Share and subscribe on my YouTube channel. Thank you so much. See you in the next video. Ciao.